Welcome everyone to a first of what I hope is a ongoing series. The idea behind Minecraft archaeology. Well, I used to be part of the server, Mutt's World, very popular server, still up, but they decided to reset the map. And with that, they allowed people to download the old one before or while the new one was being set up. So what we have here essentially is the old world map, complete with everyone's town, items and whatnot. Now, what I hope to do is find my town from the spawn point here and make my way here to my town, which I kind of remember how to get there. I never had to go there by foot, so this will be interesting while I'm trying to survive as well with food and items. Now there is a problem with this particular version of the map I have. I tried to find a fresh download, but no longer exists. This map was saved on my old hard drive, which did crash a while ago. Now, I did manage to get it recovered, but there are chunks of blocks missing. I don't think the spawn center was affected, but I took a little look around just to quick see, and there were some blocks missing. So, yeah, that'll be interesting to see what actually survived and whatnot. The idea is to go to the different towns. I guess. Kind of see how they used to live or whatever and just explore. It's like one of those abandoned malls you hear about in articles. Right. Now, I had to make this into a land mode because, or open a land world because I had to set the fire spread off. Otherwise, things would be burning down all over the place. Okay, perfect example. Look at her face. It's missing a bunch of blocks. Anyways. So to stop the fire from spreading, I had to enter cheats to stop it because apparently I couldn't find a mod to. That doesn't look like that should be there. Anyways, a mod to fix. Oh my god. No, not at the beginning. Now, the beauty of this being a server world is that people have houses, and hopefully they have items. So look at Rookie Heasel or Rookie Cheese. Wow, how did I get that wrong? Rocky Cheese, 12. Let's see what he's got. We got some cookies. Can make a diamond sword. See if I remember how to do this. It's been a while, so bear with me. And boom. So far we got a diamond sword and I think maybe an axe? No, how does that work? It's a hoe. There we go. Prep myself. Bring some sticks just in case. There we go. We're off to a good start. I don't know how the shield thing works yet, so hopefully we'll figure that out. Yeah. Already hungry, look at that. Seriously? Why can I not eat this thing? Wow, that took way too long to eat. Okay, any armor I can use? No. Okay. Let's go. Thank you, Rocky Cheese. Oh, wait, this was, which way did I go? South. South. So I don't know if you've ever played on the server. How it worked was the newer players got spawned on the outer regions of the map, constantly adding new chunks. My town was, I wouldn't say in the center, but close to the center. That's better. So my town was sort of in the middle, not really. And as such, it didn't really suffer from griefing that much because of it. People kind of left it alone. There was no more resources there, so why would anyone go there, right? That was the idea, anyways. Which actually worked out for me because I ended up replanting all the trees around the town, which made it very awkward when you looked at it, the overview map. Everything's like completely wasted except this one town that has trees for some reason. It was before they changed how trees regrew and everything. Ooh, chest. Oh, see, like the perfect example here again. A lot of blocks are missing. And this person looks like they have a lot of stuff, so.
A few moments later.
Workbench with me. Ooh, oh. Oh yeah, we're switching this. Bane of Anthropods to fire aspect. Yep. That seems useless. Clock, not really. Oh yeah. I guess. You never know. Oh, jackpot! All right, I'm gonna take some of these. This is gonna get me through most of the game. Saddle. I don't know how. I haven't played this in a while, so I don't really know how to tame a horse, or if that's even a viable thing to do in the game. Again, for those of you. Ooh, now we get the jackpot. Aqua affinity. This is that it's diamond, right? Diamond. Just wonder if he has any other. No, is that it? Really? Okay, that's fine. Diamond sharpness. I'm breaking. Yeah, take the diamond pickaxe. That one looks like it's gonna break soon. Diamond chest, please. We can't be picky. If we find something better later on, sure. We'll take that. That's me. Didn't kind of look like this before. It's kind of weird. I'm pretty sure I had like a kind of a tip on my hat, but for some reason it's not there anymore. Yeah. This is based off an old RPG character I made back in the day. Also named Joe Inferno. Go figure. So. Boom. Gotta survive. Boom. Now, what is this? I'll probably have to look that up. I'll probably look really stupid right now, but I'll look it up for the next time I'm playing. But we're off to a good start. We got some body armor. What are those? Sandstone. Can't open because of the blade. Yeah, brick. So we are gonna pop that. And. Okay, that's better. Slightly better. Take the arrow. Sweet. This guy's all the stuff. I'm really not gonna need anything for. Oh, compass. Arrow. And a crafting table because take that. Ooh, more chicken. Perfect. We'll just take 64. I might be back for these though, because my town actually had a rail system installed, so it may be in need of repair based on how bad the blocks are missing. Oops. Trying to get rid of this and this. We will take the chicken for now. Let me make a few things. Because I don't need. Oh, keep the coal though. Shoot. Arrows will take. All right, let's go. Still in the beginning town. Oh, and it's snowing. As you see, the water is starting to flow again by interacting with the missing block spaces. Ah, this is gonna be a problem, isn't it? Boom. All right. Let's see if that compass actually works. So we should be heading south. Oh yeah, seems about right. So, for those who don't know, this is the town that was built up around the main spawn point. I'm pretty sure there was another spawn point for the, before this, but I joined it when it was here. And a lot of these buildings around here, you could not touch unless it was yours. They were protected. The server had a set up a way to protect your property if you were a diplomat and whatnot. So I can only assume the same was same for here. It's actually pretty neat how they built this, complete with a road going around. Some interesting structures. Now, I don't know how viable this area was, like how long people stayed for, because by the time I joined, nobody was here, or barely anyone was here. Just random. Stuck in here for a bit. The store, so this guy has some good stuff, right? More cookies. So the main goal right now is to find my town. Once we've set up a base of operations there, we'll start exploring more fully, but while we're looking for it, we can take a look around. Like, I like what they were doing with this area a little bit, except for the ones people that build into the sky like that. Not my favorite kind of city planning, I guess. Oh, that's sad. These dogs will never see their owners ever again. Nothing. Well-crafted house. Ooh, some steak. Perfect. Wonder if he actually used the book. Unless books have changed since the last time I played, I can't seem to read it. Okay. Or write in it. It's probably something to do with ink and squids and whatnot. Whatever. TNT. I feel like I might use that at some point, but not until we find the Ender Pearl, because I can use it to launch myself. Alright, thank you. That guy. Thank you, that guy. 101. Ender Pearl. Just think, like, unless they were a mod and had the power to fly and build on command or whatever, the amount of time it took to build things like this, I cannot even imagine. See, like that kind of build, I'm not a big fan of. Totally not. That was kind of the problem in my town. People had built into the sky, and it was a snowy town, but the buildings all below never got the snow because of the sky town. Oh, that seems useless. All right. Interesting build. Oh. Prepare ourselves. Prepare ourselves. Wait, how do you you can't block anymore, really. Or they changed it at least. I don't know if someone broke that or whatever. The mods are really good though when it came to fixing griefing. So that was always appreciated. I do miss working on this particular map on the server. I did join the new server, but honestly, like, I had put so much work into the town. If we, when we get there, I could show you what I mean. I mean, I really only need one form of food, but you know. All right, well, I'm back. So yeah, they did remove blocking. Just read the wiki real quick. Looks like you can glide or something. Wow, I've totally haven't played this in a long time. Also, shields are a thing. I don't know if I'll necessarily need a shield. I don't know what the combat update was completely. One of the other things I won't be able to do, because this is an offline version of the server, is they used to have plugins that could do certain things. One was like an elevator system. I don't have access to that. So this will be interesting, to say the least. All right. May have to turn down the chunks. That might help. Ooh, colorful. Oh, I want to see what that is. Let's see what we got. Sincerely, nobody. I don't know if this is grieving or just that server thing I was talking about where all these blocks are missing now. Sucks, I won't be able to see everything like it was meant to be seen before. Ooh. Little sheep. It's a pig. Some relief from the storm as the that overworld town I hate is protecting us. Let's see what's in here. Whose town is this? Marikaka. And who dat walrus? Alright. I love how to have pressure plates. Makes it so much easier. And I don't see... Ooh, that house over there, though. I want to check that out. I'll try not to break through people's homes, because that'll kind of defeat the purpose. But again, while we're making our way to the town, I don't mind... Oh. Let's get him. Experience mine. Oh, there's a spider and a creeper. Oh, that's the other thing. There was protection against creeper explosions. Oh, man. I just want to check out this house. Frig. Okay. Can I sneak? I don't think he saw me. Okay, let's do this. Okay. Oh, this was once a farm. Oh, there's a door that... Okay. Anyways. This to me looks like grieving. That looks to me like the problem I was talking about. Nothing. They have a nice setup originally, I guess. One of the things I liked to do when I was on the server was just randomly go and explore. The things you would find because people abandoned them is... It's not going to do much, but whatever. Ooh, he left some iron smelting and some stone. Oh my god, I can see him! Okay, he has no wood I can use. Shield might be a... You know what? Alright. You Ermi! He's probably in the basement, forget that. Gotta find it. Oh! Nelly! That door did do something. Oh, you punk! Man! Getting owned! Oh my gosh, I'm going inside. Okay, no, we're running. That got crazy real quick. Oh man. Okay, maybe we'll stick to the roads. Really, man? Well, there goes another piece of Mutt's world. Well, the tree no longer exists. Once we talk about that one. Go to 14, 86, 23, 22. What's weird is this might be where my town is. I say that because out just on the outskirts of my town there was a giant tree built. I'm sorry, let me say that. A giant tree built. I wonder if that's it. Interesting. Right, back to it. And as you see, things are dangerous. I was gonna build myself a shield. That didn't work out. Ooh, wow. Look at me. Oh, God, no. Not again. Oh, there's a creeper. Oh, I got shot in the butt. What happened to the road? Oh, there's the road. Oh, no. We're running. Am I running? Oh, I'm running now. Is it morning? It's one of the biggest problems we're gonna face on this trip. The sheer amount of mobs and how hard they are now compared to when I was playing. Oh, what? What is that? Okay, I'm not being followed. Let's take a quick peek. Yes, and I just realized I did destroy a little bit of that other guy's house, but it was so I can see what's in the chest. She can't open it like that anymore. Oh, another ender. Trees, chest. If I see a bed, I will take the bed though. Change my spawn point. Nothing. Okay. Nothing to do but follow that trail out of town. What I do remember. Okay. This is actually something to note too. Oh no. No, 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 no. No. Die.
Why won't you die?
Okay. You know what? Can I do that? Oh yeah, so how does this work? How do I use it? How do I even use the other one? Oh, so I learned that while you can equip it, you can't use it at the same time. Wow, that stinks. That's fine. That's fine. Okay, anyways, as I was trying to say, this little tower thingy over here, that's how the regions were split across the map. On the top would be the region you're in, and further down to be the closest regions, left to the right, etc. So that was how you could teleport around the world. I think the region was free, but actual warps cost money or something. It's been a while. Sure, I'll figure it out later. But anyways, let's get out of the spawn town. Oh, that's a nice little shack they got going there. Missing a block though. Oof. Oh, come on, man. Just in case I ever come back this way, which I hope I don't have to. Man, that's a pain. Okay. I always have a. Admiration for houses that were built out of wood, but like nicely built out of wood. Make sense? Me definitely looks like it was griefed. Of course, nothing would be in that chest if it was empty. Anyways. Like this one. I mean, I'm sure there was a tree there originally. Looks pretty nice. Oh. That's something you don't see very often. A snow golem. What's up? Oh, a lot of snow golems. The server mods would sometimes spawn different entities, and I remember the golems being some of them. Really didn't like the messing up my town. What's up, buddy? Good to see some other people survived. The apocalypse. Ooh, what is that? Definitely looks like someone griefed through here, because they saw that. Wow. That is a lot of those guys. Now, I do remember making it to my town one time when I was on the server and warps were down. But it involved reaching Damascus. It was a town relatively close. I don't know how to explain it. But we will travel in this direction, hoping for the best. Are we reaching a hole? Please tell me we're not reaching a hole. Oh, okay, good. Minecrafter 501. I have time. I will return. Ooh. Japanese style building. Assuming they use that to go up. There. What's up, Golem? Only people left on the server are Golem. Sorry, Aang, I'm cutting through. Okay, you know what? No, never mind, Aang. Don't. Oh. Well, that's his own fault. That is pretty cool. Gotta eat. Gotta remember to eat. Oh. Oh, do not tell me it's about to become night again. I'll keep this with me. I'm using the John Smith texture pack, just so you know. Okay. Ooh, I am damn tempted. Okay, fine. Let's take a look. Okay, let's not take a look. Forget it. Forget it. I tried, then you had to do that. You had to do that, rather. What do you want? That's chicken. Remember, this road spanned all across Mutt's world, from one end of the map to a good portion of the other, at least. That's how I did most of my exploring. Because usually people built. Oh, man, I still want to explore that. Jungle wood, eh? Okay, well, nope. Definitely not going to explore now. Property of... Okay, I will admit, that scared the crap out of me. Whew! Do not enter. Oh, really? Can I? Come on. Really? What the F, man? What the literal F? You know what? I said I wouldn't do this, but I kind of want to know what's in there. Diamond sword, axe, bow. Score. That done. Boom. Alright, well, how much arrows do we got? 59. That looks dumb. I'm gonna keep that off. It'll be in my quiver. Let's continue. Damascus was a pretty huge stone, mostly stone building. Not even a building, mostly stone. God's green earth is that? Anyways, and yeah, I was mildly close to my town. It's still a bit of a walk, but I used to travel there all the time because it was easy to get to. So if I can find my way there. That's pretty cool, actually. Might have a chance to find my town easily. Take your votes now. How long many episodes will it take till Joe gets himself home?